Hi, my name is Stephanie Perrin. I'm a Board Certified Behavior Analyst at DiNovi and Associates, and today I'm going to talk about an article by Geiger, Carr, and LeBlanc called Function-Based Treatments for Escape-Maintained Behavior, a Treatment Selection Model for Practicing Behavior Analysts. And these are the task list topics from the BACB's 5th edition task list that we'll cover. So the purpose of this article is, once you've identified the function of the behavior, you're going to be able to use these 6 commonly researched function-based interventions to address escape-maintained problem behavior. The article also provides you with a clinical model for selecting the best treatments based on several variables, and it displays an easy-to-use chart that has the strengths and limitations of each of the interventions discussed. So the first intervention that's discussed is the activity choice. So the client is provided with several different tasks, and she or he chooses the order of the task in which they want them to be completed or the time that the tasks will be completed. This is a really easy to implement intervention. As the practitioner, you're going to need to make sure that you have a lot of these tasks pre-prepared prior to presenting them to your learner. And you want to make sure that the tasks that you present are within your client's existing skill repertoire. Lastly, you need to remember that this is an antecedent-based strategy. So on its own, it does not address how you should respond to the problem behavior. So this strategy would be best utilized in conjunction with another consequence-based intervention that will address the problem behavior. The next intervention that they discuss is the curricular revisions. So you need to assess the curriculum or instruction to determine if it's appropriate. So sometimes escape-maintained problem behavior occurs because the task is too difficult. It could be too easy. It might be non-preferred or novel. And other times, it's not functional or of interest to the learner. Dunlop and colleagues in 1995 showed that there was an increase in task completion when the tasks that were presented were thought to be of interest or meaningful to the participant compared to when they were not. Other instructional variables that you want to consider is the length of the session. Also, are you presenting mass trials to the client? What is the prompting sequence that's in place? The rate at which the demands are presented, are they too fast or are they too slow? And also, are you presenting the learner with positive reinforcement throughout? So when you look at the curriculum and the instruction, others will likely benefit from a learning environment that's more efficient. One of the other interventions that they discussed in this article is demand fading. So basically, all of the demands are removed and there's no instruction being provided. And then the demands will gradually be introduced in a systematic fashion. So initially, when you remove all of those demands, you should see an immediate decrease in that problem behavior. Zarcone and colleagues' research in 1994 indicated that demand fading was most effective when escape extinction was also utilized. Differential reinforcement is also discussed as another intervention for escape-maintained problem behavior. So this is when you reinforce one behavior and not others. Or in some situations, the behavior is reinforced at a denser schedule, maybe has longer access to the reinforcer or it's more robust, and some of the other behaviors have a short or smaller reinforcement period of time. Functional communication training is another intervention. This is where you shape a communicative response to request the reinforcer, and in this situation, it's a break. It's really important that when you shape that functional communication response, that it does not require the client to exert more effort than the problem behavior. So if a learner were to exhibit 1 or 2 word utterances, and you tried to shape an FCR of, "I would like a break, please," that is increasing the effort and likely will not be successful in the individual using that functional communication response. Something like using a picture icon to exchange might be less effort than that vocal response. Another intervention is DNRA, or differential negative reinforcement of alternative behavior. And this is when the escape or the break is provided contingent on task completion. And so this intervention promotes the individual to exhibit an adaptive response. And the last one is the differential negative reinforcement of other behavior. This is when reinforcement is provided after a period of time has elapsed and that problem behavior which was targeted does not occur. So it's really important that when you use these intervals that you focus on really short interval length. You want to make sure that you have that initial interval smaller than the mean interval response time for when the problem behavior was initially exhibited during baseline. And then it's also important for you to determine if this is going to be a resetting or a non-resetting DRO. And there's plenty of research which talks about the benefits of both based on your client's preferences. Escape extinction is another intervention where the task remains present despite the problem behavior being exhibited. And sometimes prompting sequences, such as physical guidance, can be utilized to ensure that there's follow-through with the demand. This intervention can also be used with other interventions. And lastly, they talk about non-contingent escape. This is when a break is provided contingent on a specified period of time elapsing. So the break, or that reinforcer, is provided regardless of what is going on. Over time, the schedule definitely will need to be thinned. Reminder that this is another antecedent strategy and does not provide staff or caregivers with how to respond to the problem behavior. So some general guidelines for you to consider when implementing these interventions. You need to make sure you're using a rich or a dense schedule of reinforcement. You know, very short interval length is necessary. And you want to make sure that your clients are contacting the contingencies, so this reinforcement schedule is really important. Also, when you increase the schedule or introduce work, you need to do so in a systematic manner. Look to your data to guide you in this. It is important that you have predetermined criteria to move forward or fade the schedule, and also to move backwards. It is important when designing function-based intervention that the practitioner takes into account the severity of the problem behavior, the repertoire of the individual, the tolerance of the behavior occurring, staffing ratios, and also your level of expertise. This is an example of a chart that displays the strengths and limitations of each intervention. Here are some general questions that will assist you in selecting treatment options for a behavior that is negatively reinforced. And based on your responses to these questions, this tool is going to help guide you in selecting your interventions. As a reminder, this is not an exhaustive list of interventions that you can use, and you can use these interventions in combination. Thank you for watching. I hope you take a look at this article and the other research that's discussed within. I look forward to reading your comments. Please like and subscribe to our channel, and let us know what other topics you would like us to cover.